Hello everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and we're back with another episode of Pokémon HeartGold. In the last episode, now I'm back to like not remembering what happened. We made progress through Kanto, I guess. Yeah, okay. We started off on the SS Aqua, and then we dismounted from the ship, and we started off in Vermilion. And then we moved on into Saffron, up to Cerulean, and finally, now we're here on the route by a rock tunnel. So that's super cool. Got a wild Goldeen He. Don't really care, it's only level 10. I don't really give a crap. Get that out of here. What we want to do is we want to go down this little water stream here. Because in this episode, we're going to get the main quest done. And yeah, dude, we're going to get it done in one video. In one fell swoop, you know? It's going to get done, dude. So, I'm just gonna keep running away from all these Pokemon, good lord. Oh my god. Friggin' water, man. I'm telling ya. Look at this Goldeen. Look at this stupid-ass Goldeen. So yeah, as you guys saw from the surf animation, I put Uncle Hisky on my team, just so that I could, there we go. Just so I could have something for, you know, a bunch of TMs and stuff, so. Figured that would make it a bit easier on everyone. So we'll just go over and talk to this guy here. I'm ready to blast something! Who would dare steal a part from the generator? I spend so much time fixing it! If I catch him, he's going to see what I can do with my charge beam! Well, okay then. The power plant's manager is up ahead, but since someone wrecked the generator, he's been both sad and, at times, furious. Sometimes he would burst out laughing out of desperation. Oh my god. We've had to go through so much. Well then. Yeah. That's no good. Alright, well, see ya. Oh, what's this? Aha. Oh, look at this, we're overhearing something. I just got word from Cerulean. It appears that a shady character has been loitering around. Could I ask for your cooperation? The shady character was hanging around this Cerulean ship. Like, why would they just ask me randomly? Like, do they see my Pokemon out with me so they know I'm a trainer? I don't know. Well, I guess the people in Vermilion were saying that, the gym leaders around. Ooh, Electabuzz. That's interesting. Now let's kill it. But yeah, I'm pretty sure like the people in Vermilion were saying that the gym leaders here are strong, so there are only like strong trainers in Kanto now. So I don't know, I guess just because he knew I was a trainer, he just knew that I was gonna be pretty friggin' strong. Even though I took out the champion, dude, like, man. See, that's what I never understood. Like, after you beat the game, like, you are just able to like play the game like normal and stuff. But it's like, if you beat the champion, that means that you are the new champion, but it's like there's never any extra status that comes along with that, you know? I always kind of wished for something a bit more. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being a greedy son of a gun. I have no idea, dude. Oh, what's going on here? Skiploom? Oh man, dude, we've got this in the bag. We've got it in the bag. I mean, Michelle Ruff's pretty good against grass types. She walls them pretty well as long as they don't have like some poison move or some crap like that. Yeah, get that Skiploom out of here. I ain't scared of Skiploom. And another Skiploom. Fine then, we'll just take out this one too then. That first Skiploom didn't quite do it. I better bring out reinforcements with another one. Yeah, get out of here with that. Since you have so little health left, I'll taunt you with Magical Leaf. That's right. I went there. I went there, man. Nice, level 24. Iggy's getting up there already. I'm pretty proud of him. I'm very impressed with his progress so far. What is with all the lagging that's been happening on my recordings lately? I don't understand that. I really don't get it. Alright, so we're back here in Cerulean City. I just decided to cut past like a million battles. And oh, look at this guy. What a surprise. Oops, I'm sorry. You not hurt, okay? I very busy. I feel like I'm reading a Newgrounds comment. No time for talking with you. Not good for me if seen by somebody. Okay. Oh no!
You've seen me already.
I make big mistake. Hey you, forget you see me, okay? You seen, heard, know nothing, okay? Bye. Bye-bye, go-go. Oh my lord, this friggin' guy. This freaking guy. This guy's nuts, man. This guy's friggin' nuts. Alright, let's just keep going. It's all good. It's all good. So, what we have to do now is, as we can see, Team Rocket is the one behind, Team Rocket's the one who stole this machine part from the power plant. Oh no! Hiding I was, but you did me found in no time. What? Okay. Me only one from another country. Yet! No big business, okay? Think I did. If stop the energy, be big panic and unlucky for here people. Secret it is my mission, so tell you why not. But, if when you do versus me, a man I be, and mine secret to you tell. No, I don't understand! Okay, fine, we'll just battle. See, it's times like this when I wish all the Team Rocket members had their own name, so that they could have given this foreigner a name, and I could actually figure out what nationality I'm supposed to be reading that in. But I have no freaking idea. I really have no clue. Oh geez, that's not good. Okay. Oh good. Good. I've been badly poisoned. That's the lovely thing about Poison Fang. Not the strongest move. Man, is it a piss off when that added effect gets put in there. Yeah, get out of here with that. At least I have Reflect up now. Oh my lord, are you kidding me? Whatever, let's just get Golbat out of the way before anything bad happens. Oh my lord, I won't even get a two-hit KO? Are you serious? Oh my lord. You've got to be kidding me right now. Ooh, nice. Okay. I'll go for it anyway. Yeah! Nice. I'm glad that was his only Pokemon. That Body Slam helped a lot too. I'll give him that. No, believe it, I can't. Strong, man, don't scroll through it that fast, come on. I'm trying to read your text. Okay, tell you mine secret, will I. All right. Machine parts steal by me, hide it I did in Gym of the Cerulean. Near inflatable tube put it I did, look for gym at. But you forget me not, beat you for sure will Team Rocket. Come from Johto, will they? Mine allies, yes. Will revenge they are. Okay. You say what? Team Rocket is bye-bye a go-go? Broken up it is, says you? Oh no! Should I do what now on from me? Man, what is up with this guy? This is awful. Okay. I my country go home. Make Team Rocket I will. Goodbye. So long. Oh, I wish he said bye bye a go go. Arnie's on the phone, okay. Will? Howdy. It's Arnie, how are you? I'm always with my Venonat, it's so cute, I just love it. Do you happen to have Abra? Man, come on. Isn't this like the second time you phoned me about these Abra? What's wrong with that guy? Cerulean, near inflatable tube, is the machine part? What was he talking about? Yes, I wish I knew what he was talking about too. Good lord. Alright, well, yeah, this is great. Look at all this poison going up on in here. Oh god. Okay. So we're in the Pokemon Center now, that's good. Alright, let's see here. Good lord, 8 health left. Oh my god. Don't like that at all. Freaks me out, man. There, get up there. Perfect. There, we'll just heal them up. We're all fine. See, it's good. We're all fine and good. We're all fine. Perfect. See, we're okay. Right, Michelle Ruff? We're fine. So now, we've got to go into this Cerulean Gym over here. And just like last time, it's still empty in here. But he said there was something near the inflatable tubes, so let's take a look around. I'm almost positive you can use the dowsing machine or item finder in the originals to find the machine part. It's also much easier to find in the originals. I've already memorized the location in the original games. But No. I don't want to surf yet. But now I just got to search around and tap A like an asshole. Because I don't know where it is. And I'm too lazy to use the dowsing machine, so there you go. I'm sure it's easy enough to find. We just gotta find it, you know? There it is. We'll obtain the machine part. So, now I'm going to meet you guys over at the power plant, and we'll return that machine part to the dude. That was, threatening everyone with his charge beam. Good lord. Ah, there we go. We've returned it to him. Look at that. Thank you so much. Now, all I have to do is attach this part here. Ah, lovely cut to black to make these polygons move. Whirr! Yes, it's running! Whirr, whirr! Yeah, okay. Yeah, calm down, buddy. Waha! Thanks! Here, go ahead and take this TM as a reward. You earned it, kid. Thanks, dude. TM57, which, well, it's Charge Beam. In the originals, it was Zap Cannon, so it's at least a similar idea, I suppose. Pretty neato. Pro tip, if you decide to keep that Togepi on your team up until now, would highly recommend giving it Charge Beam if it has Serene Grace. Very useful for in-game. Mostly because it already has a 50% chance of raising your special attack. It's a very weak attack, but you know, it's a 50% booster, which is pretty nice. And if you have Serene Grace on top of that, every time you use Charge Beam, it'll raise your special attack. So it's a pretty good little strategic point. Works very well. Now, if all these Pokemon in here would just piss off already. Okay, I might actually KO this Sea King just for the easy experience, but this is my lone exception. I will only KO the Sea King. Just because, you know, it's just some nice quick easy. Yeah, see, it's a nice quick easy hit right there. And it leveled Iggy up again. Oh, man. So I'm gonna let you guys in on something about Iggy, because he's not the easiest Pokemon to raise. He's got a pretty high experience base. And he evolves twice, and both times, they're rather late. So Iggy will evolve the first time at level 30. And then evolve again at level 55. So we've still got quite a ways to go. Again, especially for having a high experience base. That's a lot of experience we're going to have to rack up. But, I mean, hopefully we'll get through it at some point. There's more than enough material here to put to use in order to make them evolve and stuff. And of course, there could always be off-screen training to make sure things are going on track too if I have to. So we'll get there somehow. It might be a bit of an uphill battle, but that's fine. I have no idea why, but just every time I come into Cerulean, the whole emulator lags. It must be because of all the 3D rendering in it. Because I don't even know. I guess so, because like literally everything in Cerulean is 3D rendered. That's bad. Ugh, God. Okay, so anyway. So we got really like the main, like the really big hurdle of the main quest out of the way now. And the other thing we have to do is, just as I thought, that that guy in at the Pokemon fan club down in Vermilion does hold a place in the main quest line. It's still the same thing. But we have to go over to this house first in Saffron. And we have to go up and talk to a girl up here named Copycat. Hi, I heard that you lost your cherished Poke Doll. If I find it, you'll give me a Magnet Train pass? I'll go find it for you. You think you lost it when you went to Vermilion City? Pardon? I shouldn't decide what you should do. But I'm really worried. What if someone finds it? Oh my lord. Copycat. Oh my gosh. She was from the first game too. I always thought this was a very cozy place. I don't know. I just really liked it in here. It's like just like the one, it's like the one place in Kanto where I'm like, you know what? I would like to live here. I would want to live in Copycat's house. There's just something about it. It's a very cozy looking place. But yeah, the way it works is that obviously in this game it's part of like a main, you know, quest line where you have to I gotta avoid these twins. You have to find the Poké Doll down in Vermillion and then bring it back to her. That's the way it works in this game, but in the originals, you would go and buy a Poké Doll from the Celadon department store for, I believe it was 1,000 Poké Dollars. And when you brought it to her, she'd give you the TM for Mimic, because she's the copycat, right? Though I find it funny that nowadays there actually is a move called Copycat and not Mimic, so I find that pretty funny, but anyway.
I love Clefairy, but I could never catch one, so I'm making do with a Poké Doll that I found. What? The girl who lost this Poké Doll is sad? Okay, could you take this Poké Doll back to that poor little girl? I'll befriend a real Clefairy on my own one day.
This poor guy, oh my god. What a loser. I'm sorry, but... Oh my lord. Whoa. Whoa, who are you? Hi, my name is Steven.
No way.
Is it the same? The sprite looks kind of... Oh my god. Man, this is a freaking callback! To the Ruby LP, it's Steven! It's the guy who we totally had an awesome champion battle with!
Have we met before?
Oh my god, man. What the heck? That's not possible. All the trainers I've battled seem to have the same look anyway. Especially the ones who give me tough battles.
Oh snap, dude, he remembers!
By the way, have you heard of a Pokemon called Latias? Latias? Airplane? I am investigating why Airplane, a Pokemon from Hoenn, decided to leave Hoenn to come here. Airplane is a Pokemon that has a lot to do with Soldew, a gem-like orb. Considering the fact that Airplane is now in Kanto, it is possible to assume that this has to do with the Soldew.
Okay. Airplane is a Pokemon that travels across a great distance. It'll be difficult to find without any machine to track it with, but any trainer will be drawn to it, won't they? I must go. May our journeys cross again.
Dude, so there we go. Looks like we have yet another Pokemon we have to go hunt for at some point in this Let's Play. The mystic Pokemon, man. Psychic Dragon type? Friggin' cool! But in all seriousness, Latias is... I don't even know if it's... I guess it's supposed to be just Latias, I guess. Not Latias. If it was Ace, it'd be like A-C-E, you know? Latias and Latios. I guess that's how it's supposed to be. Latias is the one I always like better, though. I like the red. And she just has like a cuter look about her. It's cool. Though I didn't approve of that awkward thing they had going with Latias in Pokemon Heroes. I do not condone that behavior. That is messed up, dude. That's like Sonic 06 level of no. That is no, you don't do that, man. Anyway, we have the Poké Doll now either way. So we're gonna take her back to Copycat. Going up the stairs here. See, man, like, look how freaking cozy this place is. Look at this. And she's got, like, dolls and stuff. A nose pass doll. A cherim doll. Oh. Oh, that's a real Binette. Okay. Alright, well, what are you doing with a real Binette? What the heck? Yay, that's my Clefairy Poké Doll. See the tear near the right, where the right arm is sewn on? That's proof. Okay, I'll give you this magnet train pass as I promised.
Friggin' right. Oh, look at that. They even put the doll on the table and everything. That's cool.
You show it at the ticket gate to get on the magnet train. The rail company man gave me that when they tore down our old house for the station.
Aw. So sad. That's the sad thing, too. The magnet train station in Saffron is actually exactly where Copycat's house used to be. Right up here. Oh, that's so sad. That's exactly where it used to be, man. Oh, I guess she didn't move far. she moved like 50 feet away, maybe, in Pokemon measurements. Anyway, we have finished up the main quest. That's how you do it, man. Kanto and Johto are now easily connected in just one episode. So, we will end the episode off with a trip on the Magnet Train. I hope you all have a very good life. Or afterlife. If you're that foreign Team Rocket man going back to old country in the next episode. Peace.